one of the defining characteristics of Sandy is that she's relentless in the pursuit of the truth.
She's always looking for ideas and information that are new to her. And she doesn't care where they come from, and she doesn't have a lot of ego involved, and she's not that interested in other people's egos.
In her early years, one of the things I remember about her from almost day one was Sandy was the person who always asked the tough questions.
And when Sandy's interested in something, she'll stick with it for enough time to really answer the question.
She has this amazing ability to always get to the essential of a problem. Even if she hasn't thought about the problem, no, she does that on the fly.
Sandy is not just a wonderful scientist, but she's also a wonderful person.
The first female astronomer at UC's Lick Observatory, Sandra Faber, made groundbreaking discoveries about galaxies, dark matter, black holes, and the history of the universe, while also playing a leading role in the achievements of the Hubble Space Telescope and the revolutionary Keck telescopes in Hawaii.
She was there in the early stages of trying to figure out what was going on with the Hubble Space Telescope. And what was going on was not a pretty picture.
Sandy once said to me that her particular ability was that she's like, I'm very good at seeing when things are wrong.
She quickly realized, certainly before anyone else, that the images that they were getting looked a lot like an image that suffered from something called spherical aberration. And she said you could see the color draining out of the faces of the engineers when they saw that her prediction had actually been realized.
Faber also helped get the Keck telescopes built, and she led the team that designed and built Deimos, the most advanced optical spectrograph in the world when it was installed at the Keck Observatory in Hawaii in 2002.
For Sandy, that was a new thing to do. She was not an instrumentalist. She would never have told you that she was an instrumentalist, so she had to expand her repertoire of skills. She had to work with a large team to get this done, and she got it done. And Deimos was a great success that led to a number of discoveries about galaxies.
Having helped create these powerful instruments, Faber then used them to conduct groundbreaking research, including the largest project in the history of the Hubble Space Telescope, the Candle Survey.
Over time, its candles has now become some of the best fields in the whole sky for anybody to study distant galaxies. If you just take the slice of Sandy, the just observer part, she would get all the accolades that she's already gotten by itself. But then she also did some really fabulous work in theory.
To me, Sandy Faber is one of the great astronomers of the second half of the 20th century and the first half of the 21st century. And I think history will reflect that. She had a tremendous impact in a number of areas. She had an impact on cosmology, or understanding the large-scale structure of the universe. She had a real impact on understanding galaxies, what they are, how they are structured, what makes them tick.
Faber has received the National Medal of Science from President Obama, the Gruber Prize in Cosmology, and countless other honors for her research. Yet she remains dedicated to mentoring young scientists and increasing diversity in her field.
Sandy is very committed to diversifying the field of astronomy, both in terms of the fraction of women and underrepresented minorities.
And therefore, she really believes that diversity is an essential component of actually finding creative solutions to problems.
Faber helped organize Lick Observatory's first Spanish language event, La Noche de las Estrellas, for high school students and their family members.
Sandy just, it's perfect in making people feel comfortable, making other people feel respected, heard, and she creates these sort of environments in which people feel empowered to speak, people feel empowered to share ideas.
I've seen her mentor many female grad students, and she's done a great job.
I mean, my relationship with Sandy was the most important part of graduate school for me.
And when we see someone with the stature of Sandy devoting so much time to mentoring our young faculty and our grad students and our undergrad students, you know, it just generates a sense of responsibility for all of us.
Faber has also thought deeply about the implications of modern cosmology for humanity's understanding of our place in the cosmos and our responsibility as caretakers of our planet.
And Sandy cares. She cares about what's actually happening in the universe. It's this deep passion that she has. That's more important to her than all of the little details or any kind of sort of academic political challenges that happen along the way. Those things are just sort of noise in the system.
You know, some people retire by fading. If anything, Sandy, in the process of retiring, is blossoming.